Once upon a time.
I wish.
In a far off kingdom.
More than anything.
A young man.
More than life.
A sad young
more
lad.
More than jewels.
I wish. And a childless baker.
More than life.
I wish.
With his wife.
More than anything.
More than the moon.
I wish.
The king is giving a festival.
More than life.
I wish to go to the festival.
More than riches.
Ooh. I wish my cow would give us some milk.
More than anything.
The poor girl's mother had died.
You, Cinderella, the festival. You used to go to the festival.
The festival.
The king's festival.
And her father had taken for his new wife.
The festival.
A woman with two daughters of her own.
Look at your nails.
Look at your dress.
People will laugh at you.
Nevertheless,
I still wish to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
Ha, ha, ha.
All three were beautiful of face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had a father. And his mother?
I wish.
She was not quite beautiful.
I wish my son were not a fool. I wish my house was not a mess. I wish the cow was full of milk. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. You foolish child. What in heaven's name are you doing with the cow inside the house?
A warm environment might be just what Milky White needs to produce his milk.
It's a she! How many times do I have to tell you? Only she's can give milk!
Why, come in, little girl. I wish. It's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. A loaf of bread, please. To give my poor old hungry granny in the woods.
Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes for you. If you have picked them out again in 2 hours' time, then you shall go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bone or four.
Birds in the sky, birds in the eaves, in the leaves, in the fields, in the castles and ponds.
White to Mark.
Mother, no! He's the best cow!
Was! She's been dry for a week. We've no food and no money, and no choice but to sell her while she can still command a price.
But Milky White is my best friend in the whole world!
Look at her! There are bugs on her ducks. There are flies in her eyes. There's a lump on her rump big enough to be a hump.
What?
We've no time to sit and dither while her withers wither with her. And no one keeps a cow for a friend. Sometimes I fear your touch.
Into the woods it's time to go. I hate to leave, I have to know. Into the woods it's time, and so I must begin my journey. Into the woods and through the trees to where I am expected there. Into the woods to grandmother's house.
No one's the weather.
You're certain of your way.
The way is clear.
I know.
She means me.
What a twist.
We'll be there.
Mother said be good. Father said be nice. That was always their advice. So be nice, Cinderella. Good, Cinderella. Nice, good, good, nice.
Tighter.
What's it gonna be good if everyone is blind and you always look behind? Never mind, Cinderella. Kind, Cinderella. Nice, good, nice, kind, good, nice.
Not that tight.
Sorry.
Claude.
Because the baker has lost his parents in a baking accident, at least that's what he believed, he was eager to start a family of his own and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Oh, my God.
We've sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door.
We have no bread.
Of course you have no bread.
Well, then what do you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to explain to the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought his young wife and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was with child, and she had developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told your father that what she wanted more than anything in the world was greens, greens, and nothing but greens.
Time for dreaming.
mice are getting bolder, the floor's gone slack. Your mother's getting older, your father's not back. And you can't just sit there dreaming pretty dreams. To wish and wait from day to day will never keep the wolves away. So into the woods, the time is now, we have to live, I don't care how. Into the woods to sell the cow, we must begin the journey. Straight through the woods and don't delay, you have to face the marketplace. Into the woods to journey's end.
Into the woods to sell a friend.
Someday you'll have a real pet, Jack.
A piggy?
Meanwhile, the witch, for purposes of her own, explained to the couple how they might lift the spell.
You wish to have the curse reversed? I'll need a certain potion first. Go to the wood and bring me back. One, the cow as white as milk. Two, the cape as red as blood. Three, the hair. Child as perfect as child can be. Go to the wood!
Mulvey, go to the festival.
The festival? Darling, those nails, darling, those clothes. Lentils are one thing, but darling, with those, you'd make us the fools of the festival. Mortify the prince.
The carriage, wait!
We must be gone!
Jackets.
Six beans.
Wonder if these are the
witches beans. We'll take them with us.
No, they're not coming.
I know you're fearful of the woods at night.
Spells on my house. Only I can lift the spell.
No, the spells on our house. We must lift the spell together. The spell.
No, you're not coming, and that's final. Now, what am I to return with?
You don't remember? The cow is white as milk. The cape is red as blood. The hair is yellow as corn. The slipper is pure as gold.
The cow is white as milk. The cape is red as blood, the hair
so is yellow as corn,
just
set off your
gold demands.
As for Cinderella,
I still wish to go to the festival.
The cow is white as milk,
but how am I ever to get to the festival? I know I'll visit Mother's grave,
the slipper is pure as gold,
and tell her I don't want to go to the king's festival.
Into the woods, it's time to go, it may be all in vain, I know. Into the woods, but even so, I have to take the journey. Into the woods, the path is straight, I know it well, but who can tell? Into the woods to lift the spell.
Into the woods without regret, the choice is made, the task is met.
Into the woods, but not forgetting why I'm on the journey. Into the woods to get my wish, I don't care how the time is now.
Into the woods to sell the cow.
Into the woods to get the money.
Into the woods to lift the spell.
To make the potion.
Into the festival.
Into the woods to grandmother's house.
Into the woods to grandmother's house.
The way is clear, the light is good.
Something in the glade there.
Into the woods without delay, but careful not to lose the way. Into the woods, who knows what may be lurking on the journey. Into the woods to get the thing that makes it worth the journey. Into the woods
to see the key, to sell the
cow, to make the fortune, to see, to sell, to get, to bring, to make, to live, to go to the festival. Into the woods. Into the woods. Into the woods.
Planted a branch at the grave of her mother. And she visited there so often and she wept so much that her tears watered it until it had become a handsome tree.
I've been good and I've been kind, Mother, doing only what I learned from you. Why then am I left behind, Mother? Is there something more that I should do? What is wrong with me, Mother? Something must be wrong. I wish.
What, child? Specify. Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor, and good fortune, like bad, can befall when least expected.
violence everywhere, Milky White. Not to my likings.
Hello, Chuck!
How did you know my name?
Well, at first I appear I seem mysterious, but once explained, I'm nothing serious.
Say that again?
On your way to market, Jack. You should have been there long before now, Jack.
Oh, you see, now I'm resting.
Oh, is that the truth?
Yes.
Well, how much are you asking for the animal, Jack?
Oh, no, less than 5 pounds, sir.
Oh, why such a sum?
Well, my mother told me that...
Your mother, big boy like you, Jack, why you'd be lucky to exchange this cow for a sack of beans.
A sack of beans? I don't think mother would be happy with...
Come along, Milky White. There are spirits here.
Good day, young lady.
Good day, Mr. Wolf.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And what might be in your basket?
Bread and wine, so grandmother will have something good to make her strong.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good quarter of a league further into the woods. Her house stands under 3 large oak trees.
Look at that flesh, pink and plump. Hello, little girl. Tender and fresh, not one lump. Hello, little girl. This one's especially lush. Delicious. Hello, little girl, what's your rush? You're missing all the flowers. The sun will set for hours. Take your time.
Mother said straight ahead, not to delay your feet
his plans. So, little girl, park and hush. The bird to sing it sweetly. You'll miss the birds completely. Traveling so fleetly. Grandmother first. And Miss Plump, what a delectable couple. Art to perfection, one brittle, one supple, one more.
Mother said, come what may, follow the path and never stray.
To so little girl, any path, so many worth exploring. This one would be so boring, and one would all ignoring. Think of those crisp, aging bones. And something fresh on the palate. Think of that scrumptious carnality twice in one day. There's no possible way to describe what you feel when you're talking to your meal.
Mother said not to stray. Still, I suppose a small delay. Freddy might like a fresh bouquet. Goodbye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, little.
As white as
milk!
I was going to market, but I seem to have lost my way.
Really?
What are you planning to do?
What are you planning on doing there?
Oh, sell my cow, sir, no less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? When am I going to get 5 pounds?
Oh, she must be generous of milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes.
And if you can't fetch that sum, then what are you to do?
I hadn't thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans? Beans! Oh, we mustn't give up our beans. Well, if you feel we must.
Huh?
Beans, we'll bring you food, son.
Beans? In exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him.
Magic that defies description.
You've been looking to exchange that cow for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
Six.
5. We can't part with all of them. We must leave one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say they're worth a pound each at the very least.
Mm-hmm.
Well, could I buy my cow back someday?
Possibly.
Oh.
Good luck there, young lad.
Look at that. Look at that. I guess this is goodbye, old pal. You've been a perfect friend. I'd hate to see us part, old pal. Someday I'll buy you back. I'll see you soon again. I hope that when I do, it won't be on a plate.
Wait, that's not what I mean. Take the cow and go home.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beans? We have no reason to believe that they're magic. Are we going to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one would have given him more for this creature. Besides, we did them a favor. At least now they will have food.
5 beans.
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Home.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs and in between. So it waits when fortune intervenes. And maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Why you do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her, she's crying.
If the thing you do is pure in intent, if it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
So what matters is that everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only 3 more tries and we'll have our prize. When the end's in sight, you'll realize if the end is right, it justifies the beat.
Look, take the cow and go home. I will carry this out in my own fashion.
And so the baker continued his search for the cape as red as blood. As for Rapunzel, the witch was careful not to lose this beauty to the outside world, and so shut her within a doorless tower that lay deep within the forest. And whenever the old enchantress paid a visit, she called forth.
Prince, tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I shall go beneath the window and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Hello there, little one.
Hello.
Have you saved some of those sweets for Granny?
I ate all the sweets. And half a loaf of bread.
Where did you get such a beautiful cape?
Oh, my granny made it for me.
Oh, I would love a beautiful red cloak like this.
You look pretty foolish.
May I take a look at it?
I don't like to be without my cape. Please give it back.
But I need it badly.
Give it back, please.
Forget the little girl and get the cape.
I just wanted to make sure that you really loved this cape. Now you go to your granny's and you make sure that no wolf comes your way.
I'd rather a wolf than you any day.
If you know what you need, then you go and you find it and you take it. Do I want a child or not? It's a cloak, what's a cloak? It's a joke, it's a stupid little cloak. And the cloak is what you make it, so you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so, the baker, with newfound determination, went after that red cake. As for the little girl, she was surprised to find her grandmother's cottage door standing open.
Oh dear, how uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, grandmother. My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big eyes you have.
Well, nothing to see you with, my dear.
But, grandmother, what big ears you have.
Well, better to hear you with, my dear.
But, grandmother, what large hands you have.
Well, better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have.
Well, better to eat you with.
No sooner had the wolf said this than in a single bound he was devouring the little girl. It's a full day of eating for both. And so the wolf, with his appetite appeased, settled himself down for a nice long nap.
That grandmother has a mighty snore. Odd, where's the little one? Eating, no doubt. Or eating. Grandmother, huh? Well, what's that red cloth on the corner of your mouth? Looks to me a piece of... I will get that red cloak from within your stomach.
What a fright! How dark and dank it was inside that wolf!
Thanks.
different than good. Now I know, don't be scared. Granny is right, just be prepared. Isn't it nice to know a lot? And a little bit not. Mr. Baker, you saved our lives. Here.
Are you certain?
Yes. Maybe Granny will make me one for the skins of that wolf.
Oh, this is good. Oh, thank you. This is great.
And so the baker, with the second article in hand, feeling braver and more satisfied than he had ever felt, ran back into the woods. As for the lad Jack,
only a dolt would exchange a cow for beef.
Mother, no.
They know that those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Are you all right, miss?
Hello. I just need to catch my breath.
My, what a beautiful ball gown. Were you at the King's Festival?
Yes.
Oh, aren't you the lucky one? But whatever you're doing in the woods at this hour?
Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her over there.
I've never lied to royalty. I've never anything to royalty.
Thank you.
If a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
And what brings you here? And with the cow?
Oh, my husband's in the woods somewhere. He's undoing a spell.
Oh, Prince.
Oh, what was he like?
He's a very nice prince.
And?
It's a very nice ball.
And?
When I entered, they trumpeted.
And the prince?
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
Well, he's tall.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
We did nothing but dance.
Yes. And
it made a nice change.
Oh, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
His charm for a prince, I guess.
Yes?
I don't meet a wide range, and it's all very strange.
Are you to return to the festival tomorrow evening?
Perhaps.
Perhaps. Oh, to be pursued by a prince. The only thing that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoes.
Will you look over there? An enormous vine growing next to that little cottage.
I mean, flipper!
It looks like a giant beanstalk rising into the sky.
Itself.
Sometimes the things you must wish for are not to be touched.
The harder to get, the better to have. Agreed.
Between a cow and a bean is a bean can begin an adventure.
Slaughtered spoons don't hold much soup.
The pretty the flower, the farther from the path.
Closer to the family, the closer to the wine.
It's not just a dog to a prince.
Opportunity is not a lengthy visitor.
You may know what you need, but you get what you want. Better see that you keep what you have.
What mean that gone?
Sometimes the things you must wish for.
Harder to get, better to have.
Get what you want, better keep what you have.
What mean that gone? What mean that gone? Into the woods. Into the woods.
giants in the sky. And there are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you're way up high, you look below. The rules you left and the things you know. Little more than a glance enough to show just how small you are. When you're way up high and on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead, the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you. Explore as things you've never taken. The floor, and she gives you food and she gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast. You know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky. Only just when you've made a friend and all, and you know she's big but you don't feel small, someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone, and you're really scared being all alone. And it's then that you miss all the things you know, and the world you left and the little you own. The fun, it's done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The roof, the house, and your mother at the door. The roof, the house, and a world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you've seen, and you wish that you could live in between. And you're back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Good fortune. Good fortune, sir. Look what I have. 5 gold pieces.
5 gold pieces?
I had more, but my mother made me surrender them. She allowed me these 5 to do with as I please.
Oh, my.
Where's Milky White?
Oh, Milky White is back home with Milky White.
Oh, well, then let's go fetch them.
Wait. I'm not sure that I wish to sell.
But you said I might buy my cow back.
Well, I'm not sure that 5
are
gold pieces are exactly...
Are you saying that 5 gold pieces is not enough money?
Well, more money's always...
Well, here, take this. I shall go fetch more.
But wait a minute. I did not say that. Five gold pieces. With all this money, I could buy baking supplies for a year and perhaps a new thatched roof and a new chimney.
Yeah, but could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious, but once explained, I'm nothing serious. Would you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
Well, how much is a child worth to you? 5 pounds? 10? 20?
Well, I not thought to put a price on it.
Exactly! You have not thought about a lot of things, my son.
Hey, wait a minute, give me it back, it's not yours.
Nor is it the lad Jack's. Well, whose it is does not matter. What matters is that your wish be granted.
Money, give me that back! Oh, damn it! Oh. Get it back here, you! What are you doing here now?
Oh, you, the red cape!
Yes, I've the cape. Only 2 more items left to locate.
3.
2. I've the cow and the cape.
You've the cape.
What have you done with the cow?
She ran away. I never reached home. I've been looking for her all night.
I should have known better than to have entrusted her to you.
Well, she just might have easily have run from you.
Well, she didn't.
But she might have.
But she didn't. That's the whole point.
I went upstairs.
The cow is gone. Get it back.
We work. But you can have this if you want.
Don't give me that, you fool. I don't want to touch that. Tomorrow's midnight. Deliver the items, or you wish you never thought to
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
I shouldn't have yelled. Now look, will you please go back to the village? I will make things right. And then we can just go about our life. No more hunting in the woods for strange objects. No more witches and dim-witted boys and hungry little girls. Now go!
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you had gone.
I've been searching all night for her.
Her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Well, where did she go?
Disappeared like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The loveliest.
I am not certain of that. I must confess, I too have found the lovely young maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, at the top of a tall tower, which has no door or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues from here, 2 weeks, just beyond the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage to visit?
I stand beneath her window and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel. What kind of a name is that? You jest, I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden, a maiden running from a prince. None would run from us, yet one has.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I shall lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony, beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Blithe and becoming, and frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, agony, far more painful than yours, when you know she would go with you. If there only were doors.
Agony, all the torture they teach.
What as intriguing,
or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach. Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
You're everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
Do I know?
The girl must be mad.
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her. Ah!
For each,
always 10 steps behind,
always 10 feet below,
and she's just out of reach.
Agony that can come like a knife. I must have her to
must be off, good brother.
Two princes, each more handsome than the other. Oh, no, get the hair.
Oh, excuse me, young woman. Have you encountered a young lad with dark hair and a sunny but rather vague disposition answering to the name of Jack?
Not one partial to a white cow.
Oh, yes, he's the one.
Have you seen the cow?
No, and I don't care to ever again. Children can be very queer about their animals. You be careful with your children.
I have no children.
That's okay, too.
Yes, well, I've not seen your son today.
Oh, dear, I hope he hasn't climbed up that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I always say. Jack! Jack!
Mo! Mo!
Looking for a cow!
Where'd you find her? Hello? Hello?
I'm here to make amends.
I want you to stay out of this, old man.
I'm here to see that your wish be granted.
You caused enough trouble. Stay out of my path.
If that's the mossy knoll, then that must be the tower. I hope there are no witches to be encountered here.
Plenty of spills, don't you?
It's these slippers. They're not much suited for these surroundings. They're not much suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers were as pure as gold.
Yes, they are all you could wish for in beauty.
What I wouldn't give for just one.
One is not likely to do you much good.
Was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes, and?
And they have far too much food.
No, the prince.
Oh, the prince.
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh, who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh, how?
Now I'm being pursued.
Yes, and?
And I'm not in the mood.
He must have taken a liking to you.
I have no experience with princes or castles or ball gowns.
Nonsense! Every girl dreams about a prince and...
I must run!
I must have your shoe!
Stop that.
I needed to have a child!
And I needed to get out of here!
Where did she go?
Who?
Don't play the fool, woman.
Oh, you mean the beautiful young maiden in the ball gown. She went in that direction.
I was trying to keep her here for you.
I can capture my own damsels. Thank you.
Oh, hurry, hurry! There he goes!
Where is he? Where did he go?
Who?
The prince, of course.
He went in that direction, but you'll never reach him.
We would have if that mongrel with the cow hadn't molested us.
Cow?
Oh, please, let me compare this fellow with that of your own. I thought you were returning home. I've had no luck.
The cow!
Yes, I've the cow, but I've only two of the four.
Three.
Two.
Three. Compare this to your corn.
Where did you get it?
I pulled it from a maiden in a tower.
Three!
I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
We have one day left. Surely we can locate the slipper by then.
We? You mean you'll allow me to stay?
Well... perhaps it will take the two of us to have this child.
You've changed. You're daring. You're different in the wood. More sure, more sharing. You're getting us through the wood. If you could see.
Takes two. I thought one was enough. It's not true. It takes two of us. You came through. When the journey was rough, it took you. It took two of us. It takes care, it takes patience and fear and despair to change. Though you sweat to change, who can tell if you do? It takes two.
You've changed, you're thriving. There's something about the wound. Not just surviving, you're blossoming in the wound. At home, I fear we'd stay the same forever. And then out here, your passion is charming, considered clever.
It takes one to begin, but then once you've begun, it takes two of you, it's no fun. But what needs to be done, you can do. When there's two of you, if I dare, it's because I'm becoming aware of us. As a pair of us, each accepting our share of what's there.
We've changed, we're strangers. I'm meeting you in the woods. Who wants?
Beyond witches and slippers and hoods, just the two of us, beyond lies,
safe at home with our beautiful prize.
Just a few of us, it takes trust,
it takes just a bit more, and we're done. We want four, we had none,
we've got three,
we need one,
it takes two.
Gold pieces?
Now I'm taking my cow.
Five gold pieces?
I never said that I would sell.
But you took the five
you
gold
pieces. I'm not taking the gold pieces. You gave them. The old man took them. You are not taking his cow.
You have the money before a child.
I got this cow. Give me this.
Milky White is dead. Two.
You can never love someone else's child.
Too Midnight's gone.
Where you love?
So me.
Your own.
The prince.
So far.
The bravest prize can often lie at the end of the thorniest path.
Too Midnight's gone.
Too Midnight's gone. And the exhausted baker and his wife buried the dead Milky White.
She wants to go to the village in search of another cow.
And what do you propose I use to purchase this cow?
Here. Tell him it's magic.
No one with a brain larger than this would exchange a cow for a bean.
Then steal it.
Steal it? Just 2 days ago you were accusing me of exercising deceit in securing the cow.
And don't steal it. And resign yourself to a childless life.
I feel it's best if you go for the cow, as I have met a maiden these previous eves, and I think I might succeed in winning one of her shoes.
Fine. Fine. That is simply fine!
Rapunzel met with her prince daily, and the two planned to escape together. But the witch discovered their affection before he could spirit her away.
No!
What did
I clearly say? Children must listen.
No, please.
What will you not to do? Children must see.
No.
And learn. What could you not obey? Children must listen. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. Oh, but I am old, I am ugly, I embarrass you.
No.
Yes, you are ashamed of me.
No.
You are ashamed. You don't understand.
It was lonely atop of that tower.
I was not company enough.
I am no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
Don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me. Princess, wait there in the world, it's true. Princess, yes, but wolves and humans too. Stay at home, I am home. Who out there could love you more than I? Supply. Stay with me. Stay with me. The world is dark and wild. Stay a child while you can. Protection, and yet you disobeyed me. Why didn't you tell me, Father Visitor? I will share you with no one, but I will show your world you must see.
When is a white cow not a white cow?
I don't know. Leave me alone.
Haven't I done that long enough?
Your questions make no sense, old man. Go away.
In search of another cow.
What a beautiful cave.
Stay away from my cave or I'll slice you into a thousand bits.
I don't want it. I was just admiring it.
My granny made it for me from a wolf that attacked us. And I got to skin the animal. And she gave me this beautiful knife for protection.
You think that's something? Look what I have. A hen that lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg came from that hen. Where'd you get that egg?
I stole it. From the kingdom of the giant up there. And if you think this is something, you should see the harp the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without your even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back to show me?
I could.
You could,
I could.
Not. You could, could not, Mr. Liar!
I am not a liar! I'll get that harp. You'll see.
After having cast out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch returned to take the prince by surprise. As he leapt from the tower, the thorns into which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. As for Cinderella, she returned from her third night at the festival.
Very smart, Prince.
prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him. He spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares. And I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, that's a thought would be his response. But then what if he knew who you were when you know that you're not who he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are what a prince would envision? Although how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't? So then which do you pick when you're safe out of sight of yourself, but where everything's wrong? Or where everything's right and you know that you'll never be long? And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make, to arrive at a ball's exciting and all, once you're there, though it's scary. And it's fun to deceive when you know you can't leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, cause you're still standing stuck to the stuff on the steps. Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'd be better off there where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes. Then up out of the moon and without any guy, you know what your decision is, which is not to decide. You just leave him a clue, for example, a shoe, and then see what he'll do. Now it's he and not you who is stuck with the shoe in a stew, goo. And you've learned something too, something you never knew, on the steps of the palace.
Please hear me out.
We have nothing to discuss. You have attacked me once before.
I didn't attack you. I attacked your shoe. I need it. Here is a magic bean in exchange for it.
Magic bean? Nonsense.
Oh, don't do that.
I cannot bear to give up any more shoes this evening. My feet can simply not bear it.
But I need your shoe to have a child.
Well, that makes no sense.
Does it make sense that you're running from a prince?
Stop.
Oh, here, take mine. You'll run faster.
Who was that woman?
I don't know, sir.
Lying will cost you your life.
I've done nothing.
I'm the cow.
The slipper.
We've all four.
Yes.
I will give this to the prince, and we will search the kingdom tomorrow for the maiden who will fit this shoe.
It's mine! I don't care if it costs me my life. Give it back to me.
Give me the slipper, and all will come to a... Listen.
What was that noise?
Sir, just a bolt of lightning in a far-off kingdom.
How dare you go off and search without me?
Oh, my apologies, sir. I just thought that I might go out.
What you thought. I employ a ruse and had the entire staircase smeared with pitch. And there, as she ran down, remained the maiden slipper.
Brilliant.
I thought so. It did create quite a mess while the other guests left.
And, sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the other slipper.
Give her the slipper and all will come to a happy ending.
Who are you, old man?
When first I appear, I seem deleterious, but what's...
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
Yes.
Oh! There's a dead giant in my backyard! I heard Jack coming down the beanstalk calling for his axe. And when he reached the bottom, he took it and began hacking at it with his axe. And suddenly, with a crash, the beanstalk fell to the ground. But there was no Jack. For all I know, he's been crushed
will do you no good. If he's safe, he's safe. If he's been crushed, well, then there's nothing any of us can do about that now, is there? I must be off. I must get my rest before tomorrow's search is to commence.
Doesn't anyone care that a giant has fallen from the sky?
The third midnight is near! You are the object?
Yes!
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me!
Oh, she is! She is!
That cow has been covered with flour!
Well, we did have one as white as milk. Honestly, we did.
Then where is she?
She's dead.
We thought you preferred a live one.
Of course I prefer a live cow. So bring me the dead cow and I'll bring her back to life.
You can do that?
No!
Okay. Easy with the stick.
Oh, Jack, there you are. I was worried sick.
Mother, look. The most beautiful harp.
Oh, Jack. You've stolen too much. You could have been hurt coming down that path.
We still have it!
What's going on?
Milky White! Now I have two friends, a cow and a harp.
Quiet! Feed the objects to the cow!
What?
You heard me! Feed them to the cow!
Thank you.
but it's not the bride that's true. Search for the foot that fits.
So the prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the slipper.
Why would it fit? Darling, be still. Cut off a bit of the heel and it will. And when you're his wife, you'll have such a life you'll never need to walk.
By the prince, he noticed blood trickling from the slipper.
Have you no other daughters?
To which the woman replied,
no, only a little stunted kitchen wench that his late wife left behind, but she is much too dirty. She cannot show herself.
I insist.
And when Cinderella presented herself and dried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is my true bride.
I've always wanted a son.
And much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, Cinderella joined the prince's carriage.
Happy. It was fun.
We replied that we
deserve to be happy. I'm a rabbit. You must see your wish come true.
Don't be careful. Don't be clever. When you see your wish pursue, it's a dangerous endeavor, but the only thing to do.
Those fearful, those steep, those dark, you may lose. The path we may go to.
Once upon a time. Later.
I wish.
In the same far-off kingdom.
More than anything.
That the young princess.
More than life.
Glad Jack.
More than footprints.
I wish.
And the baker and his family.
No, I miss.
I wish.
More than anything. More than the moon and air.
I must come for a festival.
More than life.
I wish to sponsor a festival.
More than riches.
I miss my kingdom up in the sky.
I never thought I'd wed a prince.
I never thought I'd find perfection.
I never thought I could be so happy. Not the happy moments.
I didn't think we'd be this way. Cow.
Little girdles.
Darling, I must go now.
We should really sell it.
Where's the cheesecloth?
Wishes may bring problems such that you regret them. Better that though than to never get them.
I'm going to be a perfect one.
This was my father's house, and now it will be my son's.
You would raise your son alongside a witch.
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Babies cry. He's fine. You needn't hold him as if he were so fragile.
No, no. He wants his mother. Here.
I can't take care of him all the time.
Well, I will take care of him when he's older.
We had to go through thick and thin. So much I hadn't been. I'm so happy.
Oh my goodness.
Are you all right?
Yes.
And the baby?
He's fine. Are you all right?
Right.
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden. What have you got?
I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing.
What could have done such a thing?
An earthquake.
Maybe we should tell someone.
Yes, we...
Who are you going to tell?
Well, the royal family, of course.
The royal family? I wouldn't count on that family to snuff out a rat. Well, the giants will all have to go to battle. A giant's the worst. A giant has a brain. Hard to outwit a giant. A giant's just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. So big that we're just an expendable bug beneath its foot. Trash.
Oh!
We are definitely moving!
So the baker proceeded with the news to the castle, but not before stopping to visit Jack and his mother.
Look, Milky White, it's the butcher!
The baker.
The baker.
What can we do for you, sir?
Well, I've come to investigate the destruction that was wrought upon my house today.
Oh, Jack was home with me all day.
The baker told them that he feared there was a giant in the land.
I can recognize a giant footstep. I'll go to your house.
You'll do no such thing.
Well, any help at all.
I'm sorry, but you'll get no help from us. There was no one to help me when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't recall you volunteering to come to our aid.
Listen, a giant in your backyard is one thing. A crushed home is quite another.
Look, young man. I've heard that giants never strike the same house twice. I wouldn't worry.
Well, I'm going to the castle nonetheless.
When the baker finally reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted the news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This small man insists on seeing you.
Oh, princess. I've come to report the news of a giant in our land.
Where did you see a giant?
I didn't exactly see a giant.
Then how do you know there was a giant in the land?
Well, our house was destroyed, and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I will show you to the door.
Wait.
A nearby household was visited by a giant not long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now, come along.
Please, wait. Princess, we have a young child. He was very hard to come by, and his safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
I will take this news up with the prince when he returns. Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
I'm going to market, Jack.
Goodbye, Mother.
I want you to promise me that you'll stay inside.
I haven't been outside all day.
I don't want you outside when there might be a giant on the loose.
Mother, I know how to kill a giant.
Oh, please, we've had our fill of giants.
But if I can help
it... Enough! I want you to promise me that you will stay within your surroundings.
Mother, I'm a man now.
You're still a little boy in your mother's eyes. Now promise me you'll stay inside. Promise!
Ow, all right, I promise.
What happened to your house?
We had a baking accident.
A baking accident?
Frightening a young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to do without the bread and sweets. Besides, if I can carry.
Oh, why such a load?
Oh, I'm moving in with Granny. We had an accident, too. I came home to find your house had collapsed, as if a great wind blew it in. I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh, no.
So I gathered what I could, and now I'm off.
Unescorted.
grace.
I don't need anyone to take me. I've gone many times before.
Yes, but not when there have been such winds blowing.
That's right. We'll all go.
No, you're not going to go.
I'm not about to stay here with a baby when the wind might return here, too.
I know Mother made me promise, but I'm going to find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you take a glass, you're through, and then into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the weather's clear, we've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here.
Into the woods to slay the giant.
Into the woods to grandmother's house.
Into the woods, the path is straight, no reason then to hesitate.
Into the woods, it's not too late, just another journey.
Into the woods to find the giant.
Into the woods to shield the child.
Flee the winds.
To find the future.
To shield.
Play.
To flee.
To find.
To fix.
To hide.
To move.
To battle.
To see what the trouble is.
Today. I'm investigating news of a giant.
You? Investigating news of a giant? Father would not even do that. That is business for your steward, or less.
And what brings you into the woods?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman, subject to hysterical fits of crying. Moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well, does she?
Now, brother, do tell what you're really doing here.
High in a tower like yours was, but higher, beauty asleep. All round the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony! No frustration more keen when the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I found a casket entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden alas, just as unwakeable.
What unmistakable agony is the way always barred.
She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard.
Agony, such that princes must weep. Always in throw most to anything, almost, or something asleep. If it were not for the thick, it's the thick, it's no trick, is it thick, it's the thickest,
the quickest is pick it up hot with a stick.
Yes, but even one prick, it's my thing about blood,
well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your thing with dwarfs.
Dwarfs,
dwarfs, dwarfs are very upsetting. Not forgetting the task unachievable, mountains unscalable, if it's conceivable, but unavailable. Ah, agony, misery, flow, not to know what you miss. While they lie there for years,
and you cry on their fears,
what unbearable bliss. Agony, that can cut like a knife.
back to my wife.
Rapunzel, I must be off. Godspeed to you, brother.
Godspeed.
Are you certain that this is the way?
Hey, wait, Valerie.
Without you, you got the way.
The path is straight.
What straight? Now there's no path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Maybe we should turn back.
No.
No, look, we're just going to have to go to Granny's without the path.
But Mother warned me never to stray from the path.
Well, the path is straight from you.
Wait, you see there? That looks familiar. Three large oak trees.
Yes, I recognize those patterns.
Who might that be?
It's a steward in the royal family. What might you be doing in the middle of the forest?
The castle has been set upon by a giant.
Oh, no.
I told you. Why don't you do something?
I don't make policy. I just carry it out.
And I warned you that you can't count on the royal family to solve your problems.
I think it's best if we go back to the village.
I wouldn't be in such a rush if I were you. Guess which path the giant took to the castle.
Oh, no.
What?
All that was left of my garden was a sack of beans. And there's not much left of your house either.
But wait, I was to understand that giants never strike the same house twice.
Shh.
You can't reason with a dumb giant.
No!
We told you he's not here.
The girl is telling the truth.
I know he's there. And I'm going to wait right here until you deliver to me.
The giant, who was nearsighted, remained convinced that she had found the lad. There was no consensus among them as to which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her.
I no longer have my powers. If I did, you think I'd be standing here with all of you? Now, we'll have to give her someone.
Who?
The steward! It's in his line of duty to sacrifice his life.
Don't be ridiculous. I'm not giving up my life for anyone.
I'm waiting.
You must understand, these were not people familiar with making choices. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them to face a force this great.
Excuse me, but would you like a blind girl instead?
How dare you!
Put them out of their misery.
We're not that miserable!
What are you talking about?
She doesn't want a woman.
Fine, then what do you suggest we do?
Interesting to consider the moral issue in question. The finality of stories such as these dictates. I tell the story, I'm not part of it.
That's
That's right.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
Oh, that's my role. There has to be somebody on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
Oh, they're making a mistake.
Nonsense.
There has to be an outside observer to pass the story along.
Some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
Look, if you drag me into this mess, you'll never know how your story ends. You'll be lost.
Wait a minute. He's right. He's the only one who knows the story.
It's going to be fun when you have to tell it yourselves. Think of your baby.
Stop it. He's right. Let him go. Put that away.
That's better. You don't want to live in a world of chaos. There must always be an outside observer who...
Here's the lamp!
Wait!
Find out the lamp!
Why did you push him into her arms?
You wanted to get rid of him, too.
We might have thought of something else.
If it was up to you, a decision would never be made.
Now that he's gone, we'll never know what happens next.
We'll manage.
No! Jack is just a boy.
We had no food to eat. And he sold his beloved cow in exchange for those magical beans. If anyone should be punished, it should be the man who made that exchange!
That's
oh,
right,
sure. Nonsense!
He was all of his responsibility. Now I punish him for his wrong.
We've suffered too! Do you think it was a picnic trying to dispose of your husband's remains?
Oh, you are getting angry!
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing around our kingdom?
Be quiet!
I'll hide my son and you'll never find him!
Will you stop upsetting the giant?
You'll never, never find him!
I want you!
If you don't go back this instant, we'll get you for all that you've done for us! We'll...
Where's your son?
Oh, this is not the boy! Stay with me!
The boy is hiding in the steeple tower.
Rapunzel!
No!
That's true, yes!
It is not! I will return and find you!
Rapunzel!
No!
Rapunzel, my love, wait!
No, don't step on it!
What? She's in poor condition!
Wake up!
Don't let them get Jack.
We won't.
Promise. You won't let them hurt him as I stand here at death's door.
I'll do all I can.
Promise. Promise!
All right. I promise.
Oh. No, come away from there. You killed her.
I was thinking of the greater good. That's my job.
This is the world I meant. Couldn't you listen? Couldn't you stay content, safe behind walls?
To arrive before nightfall.
Right. Whoa, wait a minute. Where do you think you're going?
We're off to a hidden kingdom.
Shh, we can't take everyone.
Fools!
to hide.
Yes, you'll never get there. We have to stay here and find a way out of this together.
Please. Some people are meant to battle giants, and others are not. I don't have the constitution. And if I can't be of any help, I'm going to hide. Everything will turn out fine in the end.
Not always.
I hope the giant steps on them all.
You shouldn't say that.
You were thinking the same thing.
This is terrible. We just saw three people die.
Since when are you so squeamish? How many wolves have you carved up?
A wolf's not the same.
Ask a wolf's mother.
Stop it!
I suggest we find that boy and give her what she wants.
If we give her the boy, she'll kill him too.
And if we don't, she'll kill half the kingdom.
Maybe he, if he apologizes, makes amends.
Yes, we'll return all of the stolen goods.
Yes,
he's a sweet boy at heart. She'll see
it.
You're so blind. It's because of that boy there's a giant in our land. While you continue talking about this matter, I'll find that boy and I'll serve him to the giant for lunch.
Are we going to let her feed the boy to the giant?
No!
I'll have to find him first.
I'll go too.
No, you have to stay here with the baby.
We'll fan out. It will increase our chances of finding him.
But what if one of us gets lost?
We'll count our steps right from here.
No, I want you to stay here with the baby. I don't want you roaming about the woods.
Wait a minute, just 1 minute. You're going to leave our child with her?
The baby is asleep. He will be fine with the girl.
But what if the giant were to return?
The giant will not harm them, I know.
Well, how do you know?
I know.
But what if she would return?
What if will only a giant's foot stop your arguing? 100 paces, now go!
1, 2, 3, 4.
You must be here to slay the giant.
Yes.
Have you come upon the giant yet?
No.
I have.
You have?
Yes.
And why are you alone in the woods?
Well, I was here with my husband. We were, well, it's a long story.
He would let you roam alone in the woods?
Actually, it was my choice. I was looking for the lad.
Your choice? How brave.
Brave?
Yes. Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel rushed.
This is ridiculous. What am I doing here? I'm in the wrong story. Wait one moment. We can't do this. You have a princess.
Well, yes, I do.
And I am a baker.
Of course, you're right. How foolish! Foolishness can happen in the woods. Once again, please, let your hesitations be hushed. Any moment, big or small, is a moment. After all, these the moments, skies may fall any moment.
But this is not right.
Right and wrong don't matter in the woods. Only feelings let us meet the moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant. You must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment present. As present for the moment.
Jack! 182-83. Excuse me, miss. Can I be of some service?
The tree has fallen. Mother's grave destroyed.
I'm sorry.
My wishes have just been crushed.
Well, don't say that.
It's true. You wouldn't understand.
Well, you can't stay here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm sure the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
Well, there's been no sign of the prince. No doubt he's off seducing some young maiden.
What?
Well, I understand that's what some princes do.
Not all princes.
You know, you look just like the princess. Only dirty. You are the princess!
Please, get up. Get up. I'm not a princess here.
Well, what are you to do?
I must return back to the castle.
Oh, you haven't heard. We've come upon the royal family. The castle's been set upon by the giant.
And the prince?
He wasn't with them. Please, you must come with me. You'll be safe in our company. Come on, quick!
must leave you.
Why?
The giant.
The giant. I'd almost forgotten. Will we find each other in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods. Our moment shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that you had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods. Now I must be off to slay the giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall not forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods. And how alive you'd made me feel.
What was that? Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince really kiss me? And kiss me? And kiss me? And did I kiss him back? Was it wrong? Am I mad? Is that all? Does he miss me? Was he suddenly getting bored with me? Wake up! Stop dreaming! Stop prancing about the woods! It's not beseeming! What is it about the woods? Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband who can live in the woods! There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shouldn'ts and shoulds! Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever! Have a child for warmth and a baker for bread and a prince for whatever! Never, it's these woods! Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, just get out of these woods! Was that him? Yes, it was! Was that me? No, it wasn't, just a trick of the woods!
Just a moment! One peculiar passing moment!
Must it all be either less or more, either plain or grand? Is it always, or is it never end? That's what woods are for those moments in the woods. Oh, if life were made of moments, even now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, then you'd never know you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then in the woods. And to get what you wish only just for a moment means a dangerous one.
Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment though.
Just remembering you've had an end when you're back to war makes the or mean more than it did before. Now I understand.
By now?
She wouldn't get lost.
I'm sure she'll return.
No, I have to go out and search of her.
We'll come too.
No, no, no. You stay here with the baby. I'll count 100 paces. This won't take any time. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Look who I found.
Please don't let her feed me to the giant.
It's not our fault the giant wants you.
You're hurting me.
Let go of him.
Leave him alone.
Where did you find this? Jack, where is my wife?
She's dead.
What?
I'm sorry, sir. I came upon her and she was under a tree.
He was sobbing over her like she was his own mother.
How awful!
How could this happen? I should have never let her wander off alone.
I buried her in a footprint.
I should have insisted that she stay home.
Remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you. You're not the only one to suffer a loss. When you're dead, you're dead. Now, I suggest we get this boy to the giant before we're all so
Leave
much
him alone!
No! This is no time to be soft-hearted. That boy is going to the giant, and I'm taking him.
Yes! He's the one to blame. It's because of you there's a giant in our midst, and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault. I was giving those beans. You persuaded me to trade away my cow for beans. And without those beans, it had been no stalk to get up to the giant in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had a talent like to sell it, which you told. But they weren't those beans, but they overslept. Oh, my talent who persuaded you to steal that gold.
So it's your fault.
Yeah, so it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you. So it's your fault. Yeah, no, it isn't. Got this cat's gold bean for the house. What is cursed? Jean made us get the cow to get the cursed reaper. See, this father's fault that the curse got placed in the place, got cursed in the first place. Oh, then it's his fault. No, yes it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute, so I chopped down the beanstalk, right? That's clear. But without any beanstalk, then what's queer is how did the second giant get down here in the first place? Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean?
The other bean?
You pocketed the other bean.
I didn't.
The other
yes, I did.
So it's yours.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So it's her fault.
No, it isn't.
Then whose is it?
Wait a minute. She exchanged that bean to obtain your shoe. So then what is going to happen to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that you might oh, dear, but I never knew it. So it won't look here. It's your fault.
It's her fault.
But?
And it isn't mine at all.
Well, what?
Well, if you had got back the bucket.
We were needing
you
to.
You agreed that you need that head.
Well, I got it from my mother.
So it's her fault, then.
Yes, and what about the harp in the third place?
The harp, yes.
She waited to me too.
I dared you to.
She dared me too. You said that I was there, but you dared me.
No,
so
I was
your fault.
Wait a minute. You hadn't dared to.
If you were the harp,
well,
always
you had gone away to me in the first place.
She had
your fault.
In the third place.
Right. She had been in the first place.
It's your fault.
You're
the fault. It's your fault. It's your fault.
Here, you want some more?
roar. Listen to the roar, giant by the score, or whether you can blame another witch.
It's the
I shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes. Maybe you shouldn't have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we're going to find a way out of this together.
Look, it doesn't matter whether we're together or we're apart.
We need your help.
Oh, look. My wife was the one who really helped. I depended on her for everything.
You would leave your child?
My child will be happier in the arms of a princess.
Wait!
You were dead.
Not completely. Are we ever?
As far as I'm concerned, you are.
Is that really true?
Well, it's because of you all of this happened.
I strayed into the garden to get your mother a gift. I thoughtlessly took some of those beans for myself. How was I to know? How are we ever to know? When she died, I ran from my guilt. Now, aren't you making the same mistake?
No.
You running away?
No more questions, please. No more tests. Comes the day you say, what for? Please, no more.
They disappoint, they disappear, they die, but they don't.
What?
They disappoint, in turn I fear, forgive those. They won't.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo, left by fathers you never knew. No more quests. No more feelings. Time to shut the door. More.
Running away. Let's do it. Free from the ties that bind. No more despair or burdens to bear out there in the yonder. Running away. Go to. Where did you have in mind? Have to take care, unless there's where. Only be wandering blind. Just more questions.
Different kind.
Where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, we'll do it. I surround, resign. Trouble is son, the farther you run,
the more you feel undivine for what you have left undone, and more, what you've left behind. They disappoint, we leave a mess, we die, but we don't.
We disappoint in turn, I guess, forget, though we won't.
Like father, like son.
No more giants waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives? Day arrives, how do you ignore all the witches, all the curses, all the wolves, all the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses, all the wondering what even worse is still. Giants. No
wouldn't leave his baby.
Looked like he was going to.
Give me back my son. He always cries when I...
Now what are we to do?
Well, we'll have to think of something before the giant returns.
Oh, but what?
We all have to think.
If there were just some way we could surprise her.
She's too tall to surprise.
Oh, good friends. I need your help now more than ever. Prince, I don't care. What's important now is we find a way to fell the giant. How may you help? You could do that? How can I ever thank you?
You can talk to birds.
The birds will help.
How?
When the giant returns, he'll attack her and peck out her eyes so she's blind.
Well, what good will that do?
Well, then you can strike her or slay her or do whatever you do to kill a giant.
Yes, but once she's blinded, she'll stagger about.
She'll get angry.
And she'll crush us all.
Wait a minute. Smear the ground with pitch.
What?
We'll lure her to an area smeared with pitch.
Her shoes will stick and she won't be able to move.
And I'll climb a tree and strike her from behind.
And I will climb it, too. It will take two mighty blows.
I'm excited!
I'm going to kill another giant!
Quick! We must find some pitch before it gets too dark.
There's some at Granny's.
Oh, yes. Oh, no, 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 no. You take care of the baby. This will take no time at all.
There, little one, I know you want your mother.
Hello?
The giant went in that direction.
My darling, I did not recognize you.
What are you doing in those old clothes? And with a child? You must get back to the castle at once. There's a giant on the loose.
The giant has been to the castle.
No, are you all right? My love, why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love. Am I?
I love you, I do. But yes, it's true.
Why then, if you love me, could you have strayed?
I thought that if you were mine, I would never wish for more. And part of me is content and happy as I've ever been. But there remains a part of me that continually needs more.
I, too, on occasion have wanted more. But that doesn't mean I went in search of it. This is how you behave as a prince. What kind of king will you be?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I did not ask to be born a king, and I am not perfect. I am only human.
I think you should go.
Leave, but I do love you.
Consider me lost, a victim of the giant.
Is that what you really wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream. Now I want something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the maiden who ran away.
And I borrow the prince.
They're almost ready. You see there between the two trees? When the giant comes, we are to send her there.
Good.
I wanted to climb the tree, too.
I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone. Oh, I'm so sorry. I think my granny and my mother would be upset with me.
Why?
They told me to always make them proud. And here I am about to kill somebody.
Not somebody. A giant who has been doing harm.
But the giant's a person. Are we to show forgiveness? Mother would be very upset with these circumstances.
Father cannot guide you. Now you're on your own. Only me beside you. Still you're not alone. No one's alone. Truly, no one's alone. Sometimes people leave.
Until my mother hears I've slain the giant.
Jack, your mother is dead.
Dead? Was she killed by the giant?
She was arguing with the giant, trying to protect you, and she was struck a deadly blow by the prince's steward.
Why would he do such a thing?
He thought she was provoking the giant.
Can no one bring her back?
No one.
And then the steward will pay for it. Because after I slay the giant, I shall slay him.
You will do nothing of the kind.
Why not? He shouldn't have killed my mother, right?
Well, no, he shouldn't have.
Well, then he must die.
Well, he will, I guess. Listen, stop! I can't answer any of these questions.
I'm going to kill him.
Then kill him! No. Don't kill him.
Mother isn't here now.
Good things, light things.
Who knows what she'd say?
Who can say what's true?
Nothing's quite so clear now.
Good things, light things.
You've lost your way.
Beside the
you are not alone.
Alone.
Believe me, no one's alone.
No one's alone.
is in that tree hiding.
Thank you. Now justice will be served, and I shall leave your kingdom.
Yourself now, Jack. It's time.
Well, no, it isn't. I'll take care of him.
You will?
Yes. I'll be your mother now.
I don't want another mother. I want a friend. And a pet.
Of course, we have nowhere to go, so I'll move in with you.
Oh, no.
It'll be fun.
Well, I hardly have room for myself. Of course you can come and live with us.
And you will come too.
Yes, you'll not return to the castle.
I'll gladly help you with your house. There are times when I actually enjoy cleaning.
How proud my wife would have been of all of us. And how sad it is my son will never get to know her. Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course you are meant to have children.
But how will I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Child.
Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother, you'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes people need you halfway home. Do not let it grieve you. No one leaves for good. You are not alone.
Once upon a time, in a faraway kingdom, lived a young maiden, a sad young lad.
Careful the things you say.
And a childless baker.
Children will listen.
With his wife.
Careful the things you do. Children will see. And learn. Children may not.
Listen. Careful the wish you make.
sometimes the spell may last. That's what you can see.
I think I see a glimmer.